All right, first movement is the bench press. Okay, first thing we wanna know, wait, before you lift, go back. We wanna make sure that we get proper hand placement. So we see these markings here. Let's use the markings, okay, to make sure that we get balance on the bar. Boom. We wanna start with our pinkies at that marking if you want a wider grip. If you want a closer grip, right, then you just use your thumb to gauge and then slide it in evenly on each side. Once the bar is balanced, okay, and we then take off, lifting the bar, controlling it on the way down, slow, touching the chest. Boom, that's good. Go ahead and back up, keeping the back flat on the bench. Don't arch the back and lift the back up. Nice and slow, controlled movement. Very nice. One more. Dumbbell incline. We grab a comfortable weight. We lean back flat on the bench. Okay. We bring the bar, dumbbells up to chest level. We control them, lock the elbows up. Okay. Nice and controlled. You should feel a stretch here in this pec area. Right. Slow and controlled. Breathing. Inhale on the way out. Exhale on the way up. Nice. Dumbbell incline. Push press. Shoulder push press. Making sure we grab the bar with a wide grip. Okay, he's got a wide stance for balance, so he's not engaging his lower back to push the weight up. Then he begins to press the bar above his head, locking the elbows out. Right, coming down nice and controlled in front of the body, not behind the head. Shoulder push press. Very nice. Next movement is going to be the pull-up. We're going to do anywhere between 5 and 10 reps of pull-ups with palms out, nice wide grip. Okay, letting the legs hang. Try not to use your knees and your legs for momentum to pull up. Nice and controlled. Look how he locks out the arms. Okay, there's no bend in his elbows when he comes down. This is perfect right here. This is what we want to see, guys. The pull-up. Boom. Engaging the movement here is the static hold step up. Okay, he's holding the plate directly above his head with his arms locked. He's stepping with the same leg onto the box, exaggerating that right knee. Okay, the full range of motion for jumping in basketball like a layup. Okay, this is a multifaceted drill right here. We're engaging our core as well as strengthening the legs and the shoulders. This is good form, good technique. After we achieve our goal on one side, then we switch legs and go to the other. Okay, next movement here is the box jump. First thing, we want to make sure we have a balanced base. So we want our feet slightly wider than shoulders width. Okay, our arms bent at a 90 degree angle on our sides. And we want to make sure that we use our arms for momentum on the way up. Okay, begin. Notice how his arms, he's swinging his arms on the way up for momentum. He's not just having them hang on his side. He's barely standing on the ground. As soon as he lands on the ground, he's already back in the air. So he's landing, ready to jump. Working on that second, third, fourth effort. Box jump. So we begin our ab circuit doing 4 or 5 movements. Each movement we do for 30 seconds, and we transition right to the next one. The first movement is the leg raise. You want to have your hands placed underneath the bottom or at your side. Try to keep your legs locked and straight, and you're bringing them up to a 90 degree angle. All the way down in a controlled fashion, never touching the ground. The next movement will be the alternating leg raise, where we lift one at a time, same components, hands underneath the butt. Notice how the extended leg closest to the ground never actually touches the ground. So there's always tension on the abs. Okay, then we transition from this one to the bicycle. We place our hands behind our heads, start our knees at a 90 degree angle. Then we extend like we're riding the bike, bringing our elbow to the opposite knee, full extension on the straightened leg. Okay, working that core. Boom, the bicycle movement. Then from the bicycle, we're gonna go to the shoulder bridge. We place our feet flat on the ground. Okay, hands on our side. Then we wanna lift our pelvis straight to the ceiling. Okay, squeezing at our butt cheek. We wanna hold it at the top for about 1 second. Okay, shoulder bridge, working on the rear core. We work on the front, we gotta work on the rear too. Then we transition from the shoulder bridge to the elbow plank. So your layover, turn over on your stomach. Start on their elbow, okay? and we're planking, trying to keep that back butt flat like this here. This is a perfect example. Okay, we're holding each movement for 30 seconds. Okay, we want to try to do anywhere between 2 to 3 rounds after you finish your weight workout. Boom. And that, my friends, is the Brentwood Summer Workout, part 1.